My name is Jim Sinesco. I'm the Vice President with AFC International, and today we're going to talk a little Draeger at you. Draeger has been around for many, many years. In fact, I think if you talk to the Draeger folks, they'll tell you one of the oldest, most extensive gas detection company in the world. I was fortunate to work with Draeger, so I know firsthand that they make very, very good quality sensors and quality instruments, along with a great line of respiratory protection products. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about the XM2000, which is their flagship four-gas meter. However, I just heard news that they're going to be replacing this, or at least upgrading it, to an XM2500. Since we don't have a 2500 with us today, we're going to talk about the 2000, but I'm feeling the features and some of the way the layout is very, very similar on the 2500, the new one, as it is with the 2000 series. So the 2000 series is a four-gas sensor instrument. This particular one has oxygen, combustible, H2S, and CO. Many different combinations can be made with those four gases. You can have a one-gas, two-gas, three-gas, or four-gas configuration on the XM2000. It is a diffusion unit. All the series of the 2000, and I believe the 2500 is going to follow suit, you will have to add an attachable pump if you want to use it for remote sampling for confined space. But for a personal monitor, it's very small, lightweight, kind of a rectangle shape. All the sensors, I'll try to come up close so you can see it. All the sensors are located right up on front here, and the sensors are up in this grate up here, this grill behind this grill here. So very clearly defined, 1, 2, 3, and 4 sensors looking at you. So the XM2000, like its new one, the 2500, very simple, easy to operate. Two button pushes. You have a blue plus with an M key on it, and you have an OK and an on-off button. So basically, any button will turn it on. Two button pushes to shut it off. Once it turns on, you have about a 5-minute complete sensor warm-up, meaning it will operate right off the bat within about 20-30 seconds on warm-up, but it won't allow you to do any kind of calibration or work on the unit until after about 5 minutes. And the reason is, Draeger feels very strongly about this, that sensors need to warm up before you do any kind of change, calibration on the unit. So you'll see a little exclamation point in the upper right-hand corner when it is thinking and ready, or not ready. Once it's ready, and it needs to be calibrated, it'll give you information on the screen telling you need to do that. We've had people call us and say, hey, I can't operate my XM2000. I can't do any calibrations, only because Draeger says we want to wait. We want to make sure that, and that's very smart, because the sensors do need to warm up before we do any kind of calibration or changes on them. So very simple. The four gas sensors are located right behind this grate right here. You have a nice red alarm on both sides and in the middle. So you get a pretty good 300, maybe 180 degree alarming indication with your horns. It does have a horn right here. The horn is a good size and good loud horn. So it's a very nice small platform. The back side, we have an alligator clip, which is pretty much the industrial standard. As far as battery supply, this one happens to be an alkaline battery pack, but you can get a rechargeable battery pack, and of course you know my feelings on that. I really do think you should go rechargeable on these. But this, with one Allen key screw comes out, this whole battery compartment can be slid on and off, and you can go with alkaline or rechargeable. So very nice, slick little package. Okay. One of the neat things, and you know again how I am when it comes to calibration and when we come to doing any kind of operation using gas detection, I really believe we need to do some bump testing. Definitely got a bump test prior to use, because you know at any given time sensors can fail, and you know there's nothing out there on the market today that can actually tell you the sensor is not working without a doubt when you first turn it on. So we do have to do what we call functional bump checking. And one of the neat things that Draeger has come up with, and I'm going to go ahead and pan down to it, is the Draeger. They call it the basic bump test station. Now this basic bump test station basically consists of a cradle here where we put the instrument, and go here, and then a cylinder. Cylinder can screw in here. So this bump station has no power at all to it. It's just strictly a non-powered system, meaning it can be put right into intrinsically safe or explosion-proof areas, which I really like that. It's very neat. It's not just a bump station, though. It also can be configured, or we can configure the instrument through the software to If upon a failed bump, it will go right into a calibration automatically. And we've very effectively used that feature with this bump station, with this gas meter for many of our clients. They want a very simple solution. And I think this probably, if I am, I think I'm correct, is probably the lowest cost bump cal option you can find in a four gas meter. I like that a lot. I mean, we're always trying to tighten up the belts here, and people are worried about budgets and things. The Draeger system is very, very economical. The instruments are very, very well priced. The sensors last a good long time. I believe the warranty is 3 years on the electrochemical oxygen. Although I think 5 years on that, as a matter of fact, and 3 year on the LEL. So that's a good warranty. Plus, they provide you a complete solution, not just the gas meter. And again, you know how I feel about this. It's not just the meter itself. Oh, it's a great features and all this. It's the complete entire calibration, maintenance, and ease of operation that I really like in a gas detection program. So we have to look at that and really give the Draeger very high marks when it comes to that. So anyway, I've turned the unit on, and we've configured the instrument to go right into a bump test as soon as we install it into the bump test station. Now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to try to pan in here, so I apologize for bouncing you around a little bit. I'm going to get as close as I possibly can. And what I'm going to show you is an actual bump test that we're going to do here. So get my my camera all set up here. Here's the four gas meter. It's all been turned on. It's been 5 minutes. We're going to go ahead and install it and slide it simply right into the shoe. And what you're going to see is gas concentrations increasing. A little icon with a check mark with a cylinder gas emblem comes up showing that we are doing a bump test. And you can see all four sensors are quickly and easily into a bump test situation. All of them are in alarm. And then after a little bit, you will see okay. Okay meaning okay, it passed the bump test. So very cool. At that point, we just go ahead and push this little button here. The instrument comes out. You can see the gas sensors are starting to come back down. And the alarms go out because it knows it was in a bump situation. Now, what does this? What triggers this? Well, inside the bump station itself, up in here, there is a magnet, a little magnet. And that magnet activates a little magnetic switch on the instrument, on the side of the instrument. So as soon as we put this gas detector, the XM2000, probably the new 2500 as well, into the cal adapter, or shoe I call it, that little switch tells the instrument, put me into bump test station mode. And then it knows, because we programmed it, all the gas concentrations that we'll be expecting and the thresholds we're looking for a successful bump. If it doesn't pass a bump, it can automatically and be programmed, and we always do this, to go right into calibration. And that is really cool. In another minute or two, it goes into full cal. All the sensors then that did not pass bump will then be adjusted and precisely adjusted to the amount of the calibration gas cylinder that's here attached under the unit. So again, very simple. No other human intervention is needed. Don't have to push any buttons. You just simply slide the unit into its shoe. I'm going to go ahead and do it again. Locks into place. It goes through its bump. The icon shows it's in bump mode. You can see the sensors increasing and the alarm levels as it hit A1 being low alarm, A2 being a higher alarm. And before you know it, an OK will come up telling you that everything is good. And there you go. OK. Now, since this unit, the bump station is not a smart system. There's no power electronics. There's no way to actually record that some way on a hard drive or an SD card. So what happens is the instrument itself and its data logger, event logger, will actually record what just took place. And as far as calibrations or bumps and all that, that's all going to be stored on that data logger on the instrument. So we are getting good logging. We do have to connect this up, this instrument up to the PC, then download that data to see the actual proof that it was calibrated. But it does give you at least something, especially for a very low price point. So again, Draeger has come up, I think, a real winner here. And that combined with their strength of sensors and support, and you know, being one of the oldest sensor companies out there in the world, it's a real good platform for customers who are looking for something simple, easy, and quick, and to get the job done. I'm Jim Sinesco for AFC International. I thank you. Be safe. And if you need any more information on the Draeger XM2000, 2500 series, or the bump test station, or any of their gas detection products, give us a call at 800-952-3293, or look us up on the internet, www.afcintl.com. And again, thank you for your business, and look to hear from you soon. Thank you.